Since we'll be working on problems with graphs in this course, we need to find a way to efficiently represent them in a program. There are a lot of different ways of doing this, and they're really based on certain trade-offs, such as memory requirements, speed of certain operations, like modifying the graph, determining the neighbors of a vertex, etc. And what you want to do and how you want to represent them really depends on the specific problem you're talking about. But let's take a look at a fairly simple way of representing a graph, and that's called an adjacency matrix. An adjacency matrix specifies which vertices are connected to which other vertices. So let's go ahead and explain by building this adjacency matrix for this graph. So let's look at A. A isn't connected to A, and we're going to represent that by writing down a 0. A, however, is connected to B, and we're going to specify that by putting a 1 in this location. Similarly, A is connected to C, and A is not connected to D, at least not directly. And that's really what an adjacency matrix cares about. All right, so an adjacency matrix is really pretty simple. You just put a 0 everywhere where one of the vertices, the row vertice, is not connected to the column vertice, and vice versa, since there's no direction here. And you put a 1 everywhere where the row vertice is connected to the column vertice. And so you see that the matrix is symmetric. That is, it's mirrored right about the diagonal here. So A is connected to B, which means that, well, B is also connected to A. It's not necessarily the case if you have a direction on each of these arrows, but we're not going to worry about that right now. Now, what I'd like you to do is give me the best possible ONotation running time for each operation below. We're going to assume a graph with n vertices represented as an adjacency matrix. We're also going to assume that the time it takes to access any particular element is constant, and that the memory needed to represent a list of n elements is order n. So give me the big O notation of the time it takes to represent all of these.